Hi, it's me, Dr. Prasad Puthelam, on my YouTube channel, My Intuition, offering regular as well as entrance coaching classes on chemistry and learning mathematics. This is class number 2 of Structure of Atoms, charge on an atom, mass of an atom, discovery of protons and neutrons. Charge on an atom. The experiments were done by R.A. Millikan, Professor R.A. Millikan. He devised a method known as oil drop experiment. His experiment setup consists of a container with charged plates arranged. The importance that the positive charge plate had a hole so that when this atomizer introduces a oil spray, fine oil particles, when it is sprayed, the oil of a smaller size can travel through that hole due to gravitational force. So when atomizer introduces oil spray, so these are oil droplets. The oil droplets can fall through due to the gravitational force. It can pass through that hole of that positive plate, negative plate kept at the bottom of that. Once it enters that covers or passes through that hole, immediately X-ray is introduced so that this oil drop get polarized or get charged. So now the oil drop can be treated as a charged particle such that it can be controlled with the help of the positive and negative plates, which is connected to a battery. Okay, so such that we can make the charged particle or the oil drop to move downward direction as well as the upward direction. Now this movement of this charged particle or this oil drop, which is having the charge, it can be observed through a telescope. So we can measure the distance covered by and how much voltage is applied or current is applied. All this can be measured. So based on this experiment, by carefully measuring the effect of the electric field strength on the motion of oil drop, Millikan concluded that the magnitude of electric charge represented as Q. So the magnitude of electric charge on the droplet is always an integral multiple of electrical charge that is applied, E. That means Q is equal to Na, where N is the number 1, 2, 3, etc. Okay, he found that the charge of an electron to be negative 1.602176 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. Now, mass of an electron. We know the experiment conducted by J.J. Thomson concluded that charge to mass ratio is 1.758820 multiplied by 10 to the power 11 coulombs per kilogram. Now we got the charge of electron by Millikan's oil drop experiment. So on substituting E here, that is 1.602176 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 19. Okay, here we are going to find the mass. Therefore, the negative symbol we are not considering, only that matter, whatever number which is given, that is we are considering. So 1.602176 into 10 to the minus 19 coulombs upon mass of electron gives 1.758820 into multiplied by 10 to the power 11 coulombs per kilogram. Therefore, ME can be calculated by cross multiplication. You'll get 9.1094 into 10 to the power minus 31 kilogram. That is the mass of an electron. Discovery of protons and neutrons. So we already discussed the discovery of electrons by the famous discharge ray tube experiment, cathode ray tube experiment. The same cathode ray experiment can be modified to find out the presence of protons and neutrons. So electrical charge carried out in the modified cathode ray tube led to the discovery of canal rays. Okay, they called them as canal rays, carrying the positively charged particle. The tube was filled with an inert gas and a perforated or porous cathode was used. Okay, so in cathode ray experiment, we used a porous anode. So the experiment setup can be represented, a porous electrode act as the cathode, which is fused to a tube in which we can create vacuum by vacuum pump, connecting to a vacuum pump. An anode is connected and it is fused. They are connected to a battery and the circuit is completed. The high voltage is applied. So the way the connection shows that the right hand side is act as anode having positive charge and the left side, that is cathode, having negative charge. So when the electricity high voltage is applied, we can observe that on the cathode side, which is having the coating of fluorescence, produced a red color or red glow was observed on the cathode side. So some particles might have striking that walls of the glass tube, creating that red glow. Okay, the further experiments performed based on that by applying the electric field as well as magnetic field, they observed that the properties of canal rays or anode rays are, they are moving in straight line, they are causing heating effect, having positive charge. So the anode rays were found to contain positive charge particles, which was named as proton. The mass of proton was found as 1.672621 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 27 kilogram, and the charge of proton was found as positive 1.602176 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. That is the same charge of electrons, but here sign is positive sign, whereas in case of electrons, the charge of electron is negative symbol is given. So the characteristics of these positively charged particles are, unlike cathode rays, the mass of positively charged particles, it depends upon nature of gas, whereas the cathode ray, the electrons, they does not depends upon the nature of gas present in the cathode ray tube. Okay, so these are simply the positive charged gaseous ions are required. The charge to mass ratio of particles depends upon the gas from which these are originated. Some of the positively charged particles carry a multiple of fundamental units of electrical charge. The behavior of these particles in the magnetic or electric field is opposite to that observed for electrons or that of cathode rays. The discovery of neutrons was performed by James Chadwick in 1932. He used alpha particles. Okay, alpha particles, when it strikes the beryllium electrode, it emits a charged particle. Okay, a neutral charged particle. There's no charge on that, no positive charge, no negative charge. And it is absorbed by the paraffin wax, which then produces a proton. Okay, so from this experiment, they found that from beryllium to paraffin wax, in that gap, whatever the particles formed, they are neutral in charge. They are not having positive charge or negative charge. And their mass is higher than that of proton. Okay, so the mass is also not equal to proton. Mass is also little bit 0.01% higher than that of protons. So the neutrons have a mass of 1.674927 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 27 kilogram. Then introduction of alpha rays, X-rays, beta rays, and gamma rays. X-rays, that was done by Röntgen. He performed the experiment with the cathode ray tubes. He observed that a fluorescence was affected, which are kept outside that cathode ray tube. The materials which are having fluorescent property, they got affected. That means some rays are coming out of the cathode ray tube, which causes that. He didn't understood what type of rays are there, and what are their properties. Therefore, he simply kept the name X. So that continued. Even now we use the same word X-rays, and X-rays, now we know that in all medicine, biomedicine field, they use X-rays, and Röntgen, he didn't put a patent for that. Therefore, we are using that X-rays. Okay, thanks to Röntgen for introducing that X-ray. And this is the first X-ray, the picture shows the first X-ray which ever recorded in the history. Okay, that is the hand of Röntgen itself. So the experiment setup, what he Röntgen developed and which further continued now, and how we produce X-rays, experiment setup is given in the picture. It has got a filament, which is actually a cathode, connected to a cathode side of the battery. We produces electron beam. Okay, when it strikes the anode is made up of copper to absorb the excess heat of produced. And the target over the electron beam is hitting, that is a heavy metal like titanium. Okay, so vacuum was created, a battery, heavy batteries are used to produce the required voltage there. Okay, therefore electron beam, when strikes the heavy metal, the X-rays are produced. Okay, so this is the simple method, experimental method to produce an X-ray beam. Alpha, beta, and gamma rays. Henry Becquerel observed that there are certain elements which emit radiation on their own, and named this phenomena as radioactivity. That means certain elements, they emits radiation. That was found by Henry, and those elements he called them as radioactive elements. So this field of research got continued by Marie Curie, Pierre Curie, Rutherford, as well as Frederick Soddy. They observed that Rutherford found that alpha rays consist of high energy particles carrying 2 units of positive charge. That means alpha is positively charged. That two units of positive charge is there, and 4 units of atomic mass. He concluded that alpha particles are helium nuclei, because when two alpha particles are combined with when alpha particles are combined with two electrons, when one alpha particle combined with two electrons, it produced the helium gas. Therefore, Rutherford concluded that alpha particles are made up of helium nuclei. The beta rays are negatively charged particles similar to that of electrons, whereas the gamma rays are highly energy radiation like X-rays, and they are neutral nature. They are not having positive charge or negative charge, and it does not consist of any particles also. The penetrating power, if you consider, the alpha rays are the least in penetrating to a surface or a body, whereas the beta rays are 100 times penetrating power than that of alpha rays, and gamma rays have 1,000 times penetrating power than that of alpha rays. Thank you very much for watching my video. More videos are coming in my YouTube channel. Please do subscribe my YouTube channel and support me. Once again, thank you very much and have a nice day.